Yeah, I think one thing that civil society has been doing has been naming and shaming. But if you are naming and shaming a shameless entity, then of course they don't really care what you do, because they've gone beyond shame. In fact, the more you shame them, the more happy they are, maybe. That's the way it appears to be. Because they don't seem to be ready to change their tactics and the way they operate. I think corporations have been carrying out with this level of impunity around the world. Pushing very destructive methods of extraction, polluting environments with all kinds of toxic elements without caring what happens to the environment and the people and the biodiversity, mainly because the mechanism for holding them personally accountable is not there. So crimes of intent, crimes of consequence, they've been able to just exist as a paper personalities. A corporation is nothing more than just a piece of paper. But when it comes to exercising rights, then they become persons. When it comes to being held responsible, they become pieces of paper. And so no matter what they do, the best sanction they get is just a fine. And some fines are really ridiculous. A corporation could poison an entire community, and then it gets fined a couple of millions of dollars. Or BP could dump so many thousands of barrels of crude oil into the Gulf of Mexico. Shell could completely damage the Niger Delta. And the best you do is ask them to pay fines. And this is just a little fraction of the profit they make. For one, they never pay the real price for the product, for the resource they're taking. So just to pay a fraction as a fine is nothing to them. And then they wouldn't even want to pay that, or they'll keep kicking and screaming, never wanting to accept responsibility. So I think what we should do is to society and other social actors should team up to request to get the international community to recognize ecocide as a crime. I think that campaign is very essential, and this is the time that we really need to push for it, so that any corporation or individual who willfully or as a consequence of the activities damage the environment, poison communities, or damage the climate, or fuel global warming, the directors of the corporation should be held personally liable, so that you strip them, bring them out from behind the corporate shield. Let them go into the dock. When politicians who are presidents of nations commit genocide, they are held personally liable for genocide. So how could corporations who commit ecocide hide behind the corporate shield and avoid accountability? I believe really that once this becomes a recognized law, that leaders of corporations would know that whatever they do, they'll be held to account personally, and corporations will begin to have a human face. I'm happy that at least two nations have the rights of Mother Earth in their constitutions. The nation of Ecuador in their 2008 constitution, as well as the nation of Bolivia. And in November last year, we actually tested the Ecuadorian constitution by suing BP for the Gulf of Mexico spill in the Ecuadorian constitutional court. And the case was admitted, and we're waiting to see how it's going to proceed. Because once you damage the environment anywhere in the world, you are damaging the global commons. And this corporation cannot hope to damage somewhere in Africa, then go to live an easy life in Europe. They have to be held accountable wherever they are.